In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Friday, the 3rd of February 2023, fourth week in ordinary time, and participating in the proclamation of the word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Brother Alvin Mulinge, S.J., working in Wao Diocese in South Sudan, takes for us the first reading as he celebrates his birthday today. Sister Lucy Thuo, a sister of St. Joseph of Mombasa, Kenya, celebrating her birthday tomorrow, takes for us the responsorio psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Celestino Chishimba, the Dean of the Anglican Cathedral of the Holy Cross in Gaborone, Botswana, as he celebrates his priestly anniversary today. Let us pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 13. From verses 1 to verses 8. Brethren, let brotherly love continue. Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for thereby some have entertained angels unawares. Remember those who are in prison, as thou in prison with them, and those who are ill-treated, since you also are in the body. Let marriage be held in honor among all, and let the marriage bed be undefiled. For God will judge the immoral and adulterers. Keep your life free from love of money, and be content with what you have. For he has said, I will never fail you nor forsake you. Hence we can confidently say, the Lord is my helper, I will not be afraid. What can man do to me? Remember your leaders, those who spoke to you the word of God. Consider the outcome of their life and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorio Psalm. Psalm 27, verse 1, 3, 5, 8c to 9abc. Response is taken from Psalm 27, verse 1a. And the response is, the Lord is my light and my salvation. 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 Whom shall I fear? The Lord is a stronghold of my life. Whom should I dread? The Lord is my light and my salvation. Though an army encamp against me, my heart would not fear. Though war break out against me, even then would I trust. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. For there he keeps me safe in his shelter in the day of evil. He hides me under cover of his hand. He sets me high upon a rock. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. It is your face, O Lord, that I seek. Hide not your face from me. Dismiss not your servant in anger. You have been my help. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Gospel acclamation, Luke chapter 8, verse 15. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are those who, hearing the word, hold it fast in an honest and good heart, and bring forth fruit with patience. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
John, whom I beheaded, has been raised. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mark chapter 6, verse 14 to 29. At that time, King Herod heard of Jesus, for his name had become known. Some said, John the Baptist has been raised from the dead. That is why these powers are at work in him. But others said, it is Elijah. And others said, it is a prophet like one of the prophets of old. But when Herod heard of it, he said, John, whom I beheaded, has been raised. For Herod had sent and seized John and bound him in prison for the sake of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife, because he had married her. For John said to Herod, it is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife. And Herodias had a grudge against him and wanted to kill him, but she could not. For Herod feared John, knowing that he was a righteous and holy man, and kept himself. When he heard him, he was much perplexed, and yet he heard him gladly. But an opportunity came when Herod, on his birthday, gave a banquet for his courtiers and officers and the leading men of Galilee. For when Herodias' daughter came in and danced, she pleased Herod and his guests. And the king said to the girl, ask me for whatever you wish, and I will grant it. And he vowed to her, whatever you ask me, I will give you, even half of my kingdom. And she went out and said to her mother, what shall I ask? And she said, the head of John the Baptist. And she came in immediately with haste to the king, and asked, saying, I want you to give me at once the head of John the Baptist on a platter. And the king was exceedingly sorry, But because of his oath and his guest, he did not want to break his word to her. And immediately the king sent a soldier of the guard and gave orders to bring his head in. He went and beheaded him in the prison and brought his head on a platter and gave it to the girl. And the girl gave it to the mother. When his disciples heard of it, they came and took his body and laid it in a tomb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are almost at the end of the letter to the Hebrews, which has given us so many lessons. Come tomorrow, we are done with the letter to the Hebrews, and we are going back to the Old Testament on Monday. Now, we are looking at the concluding exhortations, and we have very important concluding exhortations here. These exhortations reveal to us what was happening at the time the letter to the Hebrews was written. It is revealing to us that there are some people who were stingy. It is revealing to us that in that community there were some people who were unwelcoming. There were some people who were promiscuous. There were some people who did not live their lives well. And the writer makes this exhortation to remind them how their lives are meant to be. He says, let brotherly love continue. You have been loving quite all right. It is true that many of us have been showing our attention and love to others, but it has not been consistent. Love should be consistent. It shouldn't stop because somebody has done something against you and so you give up on loving. No, love must continue. And then he says, the reason why you have to continue in showing that love, some in showing their love, in showing their hospitality, have ended up entertaining angels. And this is referring to Abraham. Abraham had ended up entertaining angels because he showed that love to the stranger. He showed that love and attention to people he didn't even know may end up being the source of blessing to him. Sometimes you may be involved in some kind of charity. You are in a charitable organization and you are indeed showing your love to other people. And sometimes you may be tempted to give up on the work you are doing, thinking there is nothing you're going to benefit. I'm telling you, there are a lot of benefits. You may not know. That person you are helping will one day come to help you in some form. He will help your children. He will help your children's children. Maybe you are paying school fees for a stranger, for somebody who is not connected to you in blood, and you are even thinking, why should I continue doing this? To a person who is not even appreciating. You don't know what that is going to do. It may be of help to you later. That person may become a medical doctor who is going to cure your son, who is going to help your grandchild come out of a difficult health condition. Please go ahead. Continue being that charitable. It may be that angel who is going to be a source of blessings in your family. Don't stop being kind. Don't stop being generous. Another exhortation that he gives here is regarding marriage. It is a very important point here, looking at what is happening in our world today and how people have loosened the pinnacles on which morality stands in terms of married life and how many of our children are being misled. The writer is very clear here. Let marriage be held in honor among you. There is no way we are going to honor marriage if we don't show respect, first of all, to ourselves and to our spouses. There is no way we are going to honor marriage if we don't show respect to our children coming back home late without any explanation, and because I think I own the house, I can do anything. I can decide to lead my life the way I want. No, the Bible says, let marriage be honored, be respected. Why should it be respected? Because all of us, except for some few cases, are products of marriage. Products of marriage between a man and a woman. That's how we are going to respect marriage. We are not going to respect marriage between man and man, between woman and woman. That's not marriage. The Bible says, let marriage be honored. Let marriage be respected. We are living in a world where marriage is no longer respected, and people are misusing the term marriage to apply to what does not bring life. If we are products of marriage, if you came out of marriage, then you are going to respect that couple. You are not going to break that marriage by your insinuations, by your interference in terms of getting into a relationship where you know somebody has a spouse and you are getting into that relationship. You are destroying that marriage. You are dishonoring that marriage. Let marriage be honored. And we want to say it is only when that marriage is honored that our world will be restored to sanity. The gospel passage of today tells us about Herod, a man who had not honored marriage, a man who took his brother Philip's wife and ended up even committing more crime by killing John the Baptist, who told him it is not right. He ended up being in a more sinful situation, and that made him to live a life of paranoia. He thought everything was the ghost of John the Baptist because he had killed him. That's exactly what happens when we find ourselves in murderous conditions, when we find ourselves aborting, when we find ourselves destroying life. We will be hearing voices of children. We'll be hearing voices of those we have killed. And so we want to say, Lord, help us to live a righteous life, to live according to your holy will, that we may experience the joy there is in doing things right. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Friday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily.